The first of the athletes makes his way onto court. Chen Long of China came here as the number three seed, and his opponent Lee Hyun-il of Korea. Well, this is a familiar walk for Lee Hyun-il, because 4 years ago in Beijing he participated in the third fourth playoff, the bronze medal match, and sadly for the Korean, 4 years ago he ended fourth, lost his bronze medal playoff to Chen Jin of China. He's got another Chinese opponent, Chen Long. Last year, from Singapore. The toss of the coin. Players have the choice as to whether they wish to serve, receive, or they can choose which end of the court that they start the match from. So the formalities of that are done. And Chen Long, a 23-year-old from Hubei province, has actually been at number two in the world rankings. This man, this one has to say, is his last chance of an Olympic medal. 32 years of age now, born in Seoul in South Korea. And this, such a difficult match for both the players, but a necessity to decide who wins the bronze medal. And I say it's such a difficult match because, of course, both losing in their semi-final, both would have dreamt coming into these Olympic Games of being in the Olympic final, and that dream has come to an end. And they must come out today and try and salvage something from their Olympic experience as far as medals is concerned. Well, there you can see what's happened so far coming through the group matches. I can tell you that Chen Long lost his semi-final to the number one seed Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. Two straight games it was, 21-13, 21-14. But prior to that, he'd won all of his matches in two straight games, including that quarter-final against the number five seed, the four-time Olympian Peter Geda of Denmark. For Lee Hyun-il, well, the 32-year-old who's already retired and come back three times, and he'll be mighty pleased that he did, because that quarterfinal victory, revenge for the man that defeated him in the bronze medal match 4 years ago over Chen Jin, and defeated him in two straight games. But in his semi-final, lost to the defending champion Lin Dan of China, 21-12, 21-10 in just 39 minutes. Well, the youngster from China, Chen Long, trying to win China's third bronze medal in the men's singles, of course. The man sitting on the left there, Chen Xuanzhe, won their first bronze medal at Olympics in 2000, and of course in Beijing, Chen Jin, as I've already mentioned. That's may sound a little odd because, of course, China has won the men's singles. Two gold medals for China in this discipline. But the man sitting nearest to us there on the Korean coaching bench is the only previous Korean to win a medal in badminton's men's singles, Son Sien-mo. So the bronze medal match here in the men's singles. The left-handed Lee Hyun-il from Korea. his opponent, China's Chen Long. Well, he needs to dispel the demons from 4 years ago, Lee Hyun-il, when he lost the bronze medal playoff match to Chen Jin. World Championship bronze medal from 2006. Oh, good net shot. Yes, and finished off comprehensively by Lee Hyun-il. Not only a bronze medalist at the World Championships, twice a medalist at the Asian Games, silver 10 years ago in Busan and 6 years ago in Doha. That was a bronze medal in Doha. Nicely played. Very, very physical, both these athletes. Incredibly strong legs to move them around the court. And that is what singles is about, the outmaneuvering of your opponent. Use all four corners of the court. And once your opponent's outmaneuvered, then you can start going for your winners. There we go. Wonderful demonstration of what I was talking about. Well, Chen Long really burst onto the world stage back in 2009. Of course, he's a former world junior champion, won that title in New Zealand in 2007. But in 2009, in 3 months, he beat the top three players in the world. The then world number one, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia, beat Lin Dan and also Taufik Hidayat, the former Olympic champion. So we knew he was going to be special. Oh, brilliant. What a marathon rally for so early on in this contest. Nice disguise, applauded by Sun Sung Mo. Oh, my word. Oh, the power in the legs to get himself behind the shuttle. That creates the opportunities. Look at that powerful movement. By the time he's landed, he's transferred the body weight, coming back towards the centre of the court. Good judgment. There is a drift in Wembley Arena. And it does mean that the shuttle has a tendency to fly a little faster going towards the Koreans' end of the court at the moment. I certainly noticed that Lee Hyun-il, when he was playing his semi-final against Lin Dan, the defending champion, had some knee-length stockings on to try and keep his calf muscles loose and warm. Not wearing them today, and that's a good sign. Oh, magnificent angle. Just clipped it down. It wasn't full pace smash. Sacrificing power for placement. Yes, you always know a singles player is in trouble when they have to turn and play the high backhand, as Chen Long did on that occasion. When you play a high backhand from the back of the court, you turn your back, face away from the net. You can't see where the court is, you can't see where your opponent is, and therefore it's a bit of a dangerous thing to do. Oh, that's quick. Oh, that sent a message loud and clear to his opponent. And I cannot overemphasize the importance of net play in men's singles. Domination of the net. Sometimes you can play the kill like that, other times you force your opponent to lift. And once they've lifted high, you've got a chance to attack. My goodness me, what a defensive shot from Lee Hyun-il. How did he generate the power to get that cross court? extraordinary shot. Well, it was great defence once again on his backhand. But this time, only able to play it straight. And Chen Long was ready and waiting. So Chen Long with a 3-point advantage at the mid-game interval here in the opening game of the bronze medal match, and immediately Charles Ranzer forward to talk to his man. Coaches have given their advice. Now it's a matter of implementing those tactics. There, both Korean and Chinese teammates, and in the yellow shirt there, Chen Jin, who of course was the bronze medalist 4 years ago, defeating Li Hyun-il in that bronze medal match. There's the tight spinning net shot, got the short lift, but he couldn't put it away the first time. Look how he spins that shuttle. It was upside down as it crossed over the net. Nicely done. Well, both players have caught the other with little blocks to the net when their opponent has been backing off. Thought it was going to be a lift to the back of the court, and therefore Li Hyun-il couldn't change direction and lunge forward in time. Oh, that's nice. Very nice. And Chen Long has opened up a 5-point cushion. Yes, and this could be the decisive passage of play here in this opening game. Six of the last 7 points going to Chen Long. Oh my goodness, how did he get that back? Oh, well wide. And the retrieving capabilities there of Chen Long. Well, I said right at the start of the match, incredibly strong legs. And that was on display in that rally. The one that has got more warning shots, Chen Long. Great cross-court smash. Oh, just missed it. Well, that was a great little spell until he missed that smash. He'd won 8 of the last 9 points. And it really has put a different complexion on this opening game. Think that Lee Hyun-il has got to start to take a little more initiative. Been aggressive enough when he's needed to. He's 3 points away from this opening game. Oh, goodness me. As soon as he'd hit it long. Oh, that really is wonderful. Once again, Lee Hyun-il guilty of backing off, having played a net shot. You've got to stand your ground. But all credit to Chen Long, who now has 9 game point opportunities. Super rally. Yeah, got to the net early. Commanded the front of the court, and you command the rally. Delightful. Second time of asking, and the number 3 seed Chen Long from China takes the opening game in this bronze medal match, 21-12. There's the final rally. He's gained a lot of success with that smash straight down the line towards the backhand of Lee Hyun-il. 22 minutes. And
21-12.
There's the crowd. Can't get the Mexican wave going. And Wembley Arena. Coach is busy at work with their men. Well, it appeared as if Charles Ranger was talking as much as anything about the mental side of this bronze medal match. Appeared to be saying to Chen Long, keep looking. Make your opponent aware of how badly you want this. Psychology of sport. Just as important in many cases as the actual skill and technical ability. So the number 3 seed, Chen Long from China, far side of the court as we look down, having won that opening game 21-12. I would suggest that Lee Hyun-il from Korea needs to start taking a little more initiative. As unless he does, I think he will end these Olympic Games as he did the Beijing Olympic Games at number 4 in the men's singles. Ah, now that's better movement. Yeah, what a difference. Well, these two men, no strangers to each other, because this is the sixth meeting between them. And actually, the last time they played, although Lee Hyun-il has only won two of the previous five, he did win the last one, which was the semi-final of the Swiss Grand Prix earlier this year. Won him two straight games on that occasion. This is very, very different scenario. The pressures, the expectations. Oh, that's incredible. What a defensive block. Well, Chen Long, in trying to retrieve this shuttle, scrapes his hand along the ground. I think he may have drawn a little bit of blood there. Yeah, there's the tournament doctor. Martin Fullstrom from Sweden. It's not a problem to Chen Long. But the rules of sport nowadays dictate that all blood injuries must be treated immediately. How long the plaster will stay in place because of the perspiration from the hand. Now I've seen him do this before. Yeah, looking at the little graze on his finger. Take more than that to stop him playing this match. Much better start to this second game by the left-hander, Lee Hyun-il. Well, it had already been called a fault by umpire Grace Cheer. Struck the shuttle before it had crossed over the net. Chen Long, but Lee Hyun-il got it back anyway. Ooh. Ooh, I'm not sure I agree with the call. But justice as Lee Hyun-il won the point anyway. Well, it's called good. Chen Long is incensed by the call, appeals to the umpire. No overrule is forthcoming. Ooh. It was desperately close. Difficult to know whether it caught the outside edge of the line. But the call stands, so it's a 6-1 lead for Lee Hyun-il. Oh, that's a brilliantly constructed rally from the left-hander. And no wonder his coaching bench and his fans applaud. Oh, he's just been prepared to command the rallies a little bit more. Lee Hyun-il. What a contrast to that opening game. Now errors from Chen Long. Oh, but that's nice. Well, that was a run of 8 straight points. Love one to 8-1. And Chen Long will be mightily relieved to have stopped that run. That's going to go wide. Well, that's a couple of sloppy points. Unforced errors from Lee Hyun-il. Played so well to build that 8-1 lead, and all of a sudden the difference is just 3 points, and all of a sudden Chen Long believes that the gap can be closed. Yeah, super reactions, great awareness of where the gap was on his opponent's side of the court. He's on a run of 6 straight points. Chen Long. And now, just 1 point the deficit. That's a great smash. Oh, that's extraordinary. Little run from both men. 8 straight points to Lee Hyun-il. Then 6 straight points in response by Chen Long. Smash may have been going wide. Purely academic, of course, because... Oh, I think it was too. Yeah, Lee Hyun-il himself wondering. Shake of the head from Chen Long, because he knows that as soon as he was forced to turn to play that backhand from deep in court, he was in trouble. Decision at the back of the court costing Lee Hyun-il. Yeah, has a look, takes it underarm, and from that moment he was in trouble. Long of the back line, back level. Advantage is with Lee Hyun-il at the mid-game interval. And boy, it just one solid 3 point. You can see clearly from that how our badminton players got their back to the net when they're forced to play the high backhand or the backhand from deep in court. Tall athlete as far as badminton is concerned, Chen Long. 189 at 6'2". had a wonderful end last year, did Chen Long. Won four tournaments, including three Super Series events back-to-back, the China Masters, Japan and Denmark. Got a couple of victories over Lee Chong Wei in those tournaments too. Well, at least he stood his ground. Lee Hyun-il being guilty in the opening game of backing off from the net, having played a net shot there, stood his ground, but just couldn't kill the shuffle because of the quality of the net shot from this man. All level again. Working so hard now, Chen Long. Real intensity on retrieving the shuttle. Just wide. Well, that's just about a perfect net shot, isn't it? Precision play from Lee Hyun-il. Just guides the shuttle across court. It hits the top of the tape, trickles over. And back into the lead once more. It's landed in. Misjudgment by Lee Hyun-il. Oh, we've talked a lot all week about the lengthways drift. There's a sideways drift as well. Women's singles champion there. That's wonderful. All set up once again with a tight spinning net shot. It forced the shorter lift. And Chen Long had to be deep in his base position, waiting for a smash. And then the delicate little drop shot from Lee Hyun-il. You can always tell how deep the lift has been by looking at where the player's feet were playing the overhead shot, where their feet are landing. You could see from that Lee Hyun-il was nowhere near the double service line. Goodness, he was quick onto that. And he had to move from the front of the court. He plays that delightful net shot and then ready to pounce. Immediately apologises. The apology for hitting his opponent. It's Lee Yongbo, head coach. Creeping ever closer towards this 21 points required to take the second game. Oh, on the turn of serve from Chen Long. On the left as we look at them, looking very concerned indeed. Oh, that was going out too. Good judgment. Well, all set up with a lovely backhand. And now Lee Hyun-il just 2 points away from taking this second game. Now just the 1 point required. 5 game point opportunities. Wonderful. It is one game all in this bronze medal match. 21-15. The second game to the number 7 seed, Lee Hyun-il. And we will be treated to a third and deciding game. Thank you. Olympic bronze medalist from the Sydney Games in 2000, using all of his allotted time. The Korean coaches departed to go back to their seats some time ago. Absolutely imperative for both athletes to get off to a good start in this deciding game. So the umpire, Grace Cheer, calls for the start of the deciding game. And a good start by the number three seed from China, Chen Long. Li Hyun-il for a second consecutive Olympics, contesting for the bronze medal. 4 years ago, he ended up fourth. Agonizing match it was, lasting an hour and 19 minutes against Chen Jin. Oh, we're already 53 minutes into this match. Oh, good net play. And that's wide. I said right at the start of the match, control of the front of the court was vital. That net exchange won by Chen Long. And again. Well, the Korean really can't afford to let his opponent get too far in front. Of course, both players have enjoyed more success from this near side of the court. And that's where Li Hyun-il will finish the match from. But if it's too much of a deficit, it could be a big problem. Oh, that was quick. Good smash down the forehand side of Li Hyun-il. Anticipated that the defensive shot would be straight. Rush forward to make the kill. he's missed it. And that looked a nervous shot to me from Chen Long. Very tight, isn't it? I think this is going to be just as much as anything about who handles the pressure better. Carefully at it, made the right decision in the end. Oh, magnificent. Brilliant smash, brilliant angle. He leapt from his base position in the centre of the court. Leap in the air, and able to take the shuttle early and create the angle. Oh, four straight points. This is dangerous times for Lee Hyun-il. Just sensed that was a must-win rally for Lee Hyun-il. Chen Long was just beginning. It appeared to be pulling away. Oh, that's super. What a lovely shot. And a reverse slice, straight drop from Chen Long. The action here, just rolling the racket head at the last moment, playing the straight drop shot. Just over the hour mark now. This match has been in progress. Oh, that's nice. All credit to Chen Long. Been more proactive in this deciding game so far. Superb. Wonderful reactions on the backhand. And a 6-point advantage in the deciding game for China's Chen Long. Well, Hyun-il is finishing the match at the better end of the court. Dr. Kang, president of the BWF, Badminton World Federation. He may be finishing the better end, but I can't help but wonder whether he's left himself too much work to do, too many points to catch up. Well, it's now or never as far as Lee Hyun-il is concerned. This is his last Olympic Games at the age of 32. He's already retired 3 times and come back 3 times. He won't come back again. It's a good start since the change of ends for the Korean. Well, it's 3 or 4 times now Chen Long has played that magnificent backhand. A flat push down his backhand side. He reacts so quickly and he's played a winner. Net shot. In fact, perfect net shot. Of course, China and Korea have been the two most successful teams, nations in the history of badminton at the Olympics. Total of 30 medals to China, 17 to Korea, the number 1 and 2 on the medals table as far as badminton is concerned. Now badminton in its 6th Olympic Games. Oh, what a rally. Sheer physicality of both men producing a super match. Well, that was brave play from Lee Hyun-il. Look at how he's hovering around the net, ready to pounce. Oh, he's missed it. Well, it was a 6 points difference between the two players at the mid-game interval, and it is once again. Well, he was very cool as he played that final smash, Lee Hyun-il. Considering he just made an error down his opponent's backhand side, choosing to go forehand. Has to start closing this gap if he wants to win the bronze medal. Me, was that nerves? Oh, the 6 point deficit has been halved. Oh, dear me. Well, the nerves from both men quite obvious. But understandable. Desperate times now for the Korean. Oh,
Well, great courage from Lee Hyun-il. Oh yes, what a super shot from Chen Long. Little hold and at the last moment flicked over the head of his opponent. An important point. Oh, and it's a magnificent rally. Incredible badminton. It could have heard a pin drop here. Too loose from Lee Hyun-il, and Chen Long is quite simply far too good not to make a mistake like that count in his favour. 3 points away, the number three seed Chen Long from securing the bronze medal. But he's got to put that out of his mind. Perhaps a nervous shot, perhaps a little intimidated by the fact that Lee Hyun-il was ready to pounce at the net. Two tantalizing points from a medal. Oh my goodness, good net shot. Oh, the shuttle sat on the top of the net and fell back the Korean side. And now Chen Long of China has 6 match point opportunities. The despair for the Korean coaches. One match point saved by the Korean. Still another 5 opportunities though for Chen Long. Chen Long not ready. Oh, he's done it. The number 3 seed, Chen Long from China, is the Olympic bronze medalist. Heartache for Lee Hyun-il. For the 2nd consecutive Olympics, he has to settle for 4th. He fought so bravely. But Chen Long got off to a good start in the deciding game, and that was decisive. Throws his shirts into the crowd, and the Chinese fans celebrate. 21-12, 15-21, 21-15 in the deciding game. The racket's going to go as well. A lucky fan, a wonderful souvenir. An hour and 20 minutes. Well, we suspected that it would be a hard-fought contest. Both very physical, very fit athletes. But the winner of the bronze medal is Chen Long from China. Delight for him. Gold medal match to be played later today. And of course that involves the defending Olympic champion from China, Lin Dan, against Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. But the bronze medal has been decided, and that's how it finished. Delight and relief. And that goes
goes for the coaches too. So confirmation of the score, 21-12, 15-21, 21-15 in the deciding game in a match lasting an hour and 20 minutes. Two shots along this rally. That was in the opening game.